You and that I are an enormous collection of habits, ways of thinking and acting that we do effortlessly without giving it much thought. I'm always trying to upgrade my existing habits to urge better results, so naturally I picked up the book High Performance Habits by Brendon Bouchard. Author Brenda Bouchard has trained almost 2 million people online in the area of high performance, and over the last 3 years he's issued surveys, collected data and compared before and after results of all his students. He did this to get the habits of the best performers. There are many great habits during this book, but there are three habits particularly that I've personally incorporated into my life over the last 4 weeks that have led to a spike in my performance and productivity. The three habits are tension, intention, necessity through identity, and bringing my A game. Habit number one, tension. Intention. Late one night, Brendon Bouchard was asked by struggling Silicon Valley CEO to induce on a plane and fly bento. In city, the CEO was on the verge of burnout and he was looking for the simplest way to urge the enjoyment back in his life. The issues in his business were weighing him down and preventing him from being present together with his wife. Reception. The relationship between the CEO and his wife was falling apart. Luckily, Brendon had seen his pattern many times before and he knew of a habit that the CEO could incorporate into his life to urge back to his high-performing self and be more present together with his wife. That evening, the CEO went home to do the new habit. When he pulled into the driveway, he took a second and closed his eyes and repeated the word release to himself. As he repeated the word release, he commanded his body to release all the tension in his shoulders, his neck, his face and his jaw. Then he went all the way down to his back and his legs. After he felt the tension leave his body, he asked himself, "What is the first feeling I need to bring into my home?" By asking that question, he began to generate the emotio, and as he would wish to be fully present together with his wife and be the simplest possible husband he might be that evening. The CEO walked into the house that evening feeling sort of a new man. Later that night, he wrote Brendon an email. Within the email he wrote, "We just had the most wonderful night. I'm at a loss how to describe it. For the primary time in a long time, I would like you to grasp that I feel like I used to be alive again." The strategy that Brendon taught the CEO that night is based on the reality that several high performers tap into. Most high performers know that they need the ability to generate whatever feelings they need in any situation. They do not should carry around the emotions of the day. They don't have to take a seat back and hope to feel the way they require to feel. Brendon says it's so thoroughly obvious that top performers are generating the sentiments they want more often than taking the emotions that land on them. Just like the struggling CEO, we are able to choose what emotions we wish to bring into any situation. We will like better to release emotions that are holding us back and bring constructive emotions into every situation we enter. The secret is to release tension and set an intention during every major transition during the day. When we go from engaging at our desk to enter a gathering, we release the strain interface in our shoulders and that we ask, "What feeling do I would like to bring into this meeting?" You opt to bring emotions of curiosity and patience when you're going from the office or from school to home. You may release the tension in your face in your shoulders and then ask, "What feeling do I need to bring into my home?" You may value more highly to bring appreciation of heat, and if you're going from the house to the gym, you release the strain interface in your shoulders and you ask yourself, "What feelings do I need to bring around the gym?" You could favor to bring the next level of intensity than you've had all day. Each transition during the day could be a chance to make a habit of releasing the tension, then setting an intention of the feeling that you simply want to bring back the next situation. Habit number two, necessity through the identity of all the emotions that high performers choose to generate. A sense of necessity may be the strongest. Musician Bob Marley once said that you never know how strong you are. To be strong is your only option. The legendary Chinese general Sun Tzu said that when his armies fought in situations they have nowhere to retreat because they have a mountain or ocean in their back. They have been fighting on the land of death and fought three times with maximum force. Like Bob Marley and high performers know that as humans they are creatures of necessity. If something happens, the high performers usually do not hope to perform they do well, but they create situations and mindsets where they have to do well. They do this by creating a sense of identity about their endeavors and goals. "I cannot imagine doing anything other than that." When it is what you do is who are able to push yourself beyond what other elite athletes can enjoy with hard training, but they do it because they see themselves as an extreme athlete and strenuous exercise is what the elite athletes need to do. appearing in the gym again and again to push themselves beyond the pain. I've learned to create a sense of necessity through identity by incorporating the next habit into my daily routine. As I sit down to work on an important goal, personal is like creating this YouTube channel, and I am not particularly motivated. I think to myself that this is who I am. This is what I do. I cultivate a sense of identity about doing what I need to do to achieve my goal. I've noticed I'm stressing myself more than ever, because if I don't, I'm going to be inconsistent with who I am as a content creator. Feeling inconsistent feels terrible and downright unacceptable. By cultivating feelings of identity about what I'm doing, I'm creating an emotional death land. There is no place to hold back. I have to do what is in keeping with my habit of identity number 3, which makes high-performing players inspired by a sense of purpose that makes sense now. But our culture makes us believe that having a goal means helping millions or changing the world. But Brendon found that the owner's top performers often focus on just one person, not millions, not even a group of people, just some answers during his interviews with high performers. If she needed me, didn't want him to suffer, or wanted to do it for her, she wanted to know that we can harness the power of goal and raise our performance to the highest level by finding one person helping means we don't need to spend years searching for a major task. We just need to find one person we want to strive for to find that person. Bouchard recommends developing a habit of asking who needs it. Game is this question makes you look beyond your individual performance or your feelings. By asking this question, you need to be your best in order to help others, which allows you to achieve high performance faster and stay there longer. Whoever needs my game. Every time my focus starts to weaken when I ask who needs a game, I imagine one person who can benefit from my work. Usually someone from one of my video comments says he is struggling but finds my videos help me put together this picture. A person in mind to focus and commit to my profession. When you ask someone who needs a game, you might think about a family member, teammate or client you want to help. In the end, we are a set of habits, and by adopting high performance habits we can live a privileged life. As a great football coach Vince Lombardi once said, that a person's quality of life is directly proportional to their commitment to excellence, which was a key message that I gathered from high performance habits. As always, thanks for